Hallo, mijn naam is Tom van der Wegen, VRT-journalist. En een jaar lang heb ik me hier op de Stanford Universiteit in Californië laten rondleiden in de wonderenwereld van de artificiële intelligentie. En waarom hier wel? Dit is het hart van Silicon Valley. Hier is het eigenlijk allemaal begonnen. Kom, ik leg het jullie even uit.
De Universiteit van Stanford is de plek waar grote techbedrijven zoals Google, Netflix, Yahoo en EA Games geboren werden. Een plek met heel wat bollebozen en Nobelprijswinnaars. Zo was het deze professor, John McCarthy, die de term artificiële intelligentie in de jaren 50 heeft uitgevonden. Vandaag komen studenten vanuit de hele wereld naar hier om alles over AI te leren, ook journalisten dus.
Hi, I'm Geraldine Moriba. I'm a journalist. I've worked in network news, cable news. I've worked in radio. And I'm at Stanford right now as a Knight Fellow. My research primarily is about bias in journalism and whether or not we can use artificial intelligence to combat that bias.
Geraldine, together we've been studying AI for the whole year.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was amazing,
right? It was amazing.
A new world opening up. What did you learn? Very shortly, how should we understand artificial intelligence?
So I think what's most important is, first of all, the phrase artificial intelligence is a misnomer. People think that it means robots and machines and scary things, but it's actually just math, it's just algorithms. So for me, a lot of this year was really figuring out applications and how, as journalists, we can use it in really smart ways to make our journalism go deeper analytically, how we can look at data and come to conclusions, but also how we can make our job easier so that we're not spending hours and hours doing things that can be automated. I think it's going to make our industry even better than it already is.
You're talking about journalism, but not only journalism can be benefiting from AI. What else could it be very useful?
Oh my gosh, it's useful in everything from monitor our health. We can use it for in our banking systems, in schools, in education. We can use it in healthcare and should be using it in healthcare. And you know, one of the things that I've given a lot of thought to this year is the fact that when you think about AI, and there's a lot of discussion around the biases in the codes, we create those biases as human beings. So I've been spending my time really to find ways to flag our biases so that we can build stronger and better codes that are fair.
You mentioned already, the difficult understanding of people in general. I mean, a lot of people are afraid of artificial intelligence. Should we be afraid?
I think that artificial intelligence is like any great scientific breakthrough, any technology that's new. It can be used in very harmful, irresponsible ways, absolutely. We need to use AI cautiously, but it can also be used in beneficial ways.
How difficult is it to study AI?
If I was in high school, I absolutely would be learning how to code, and not just because, you know, one day I might be a computer programmer, not for those reasons, but because it makes me more able to understand the things in my society. It also makes me absolutely much more qualified for more jobs. But everything that we do is touched by technology today. So if I was in high school, no question, I'd want to know how to code. And even if it's just for the pleasure and the fun of learning how to build a game.
Oh yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Zo, hopelijk zijn jullie nu ietsje wijzer geworden. Je ziet het, artificiële intelligentie is niet echt iets om schrik van te hebben. Hoe meer we erover weten, hoe meer we erover leren, hoe meer het ons als mens kan versterken en hoe de hele wereld ten goede kan komen. Aan jullie nu om er ook in te vliegen.